A few years after World War II, Soviet scientists began experimenting with human beings to investigate the mysteries of parapsychology. One of these experiments, conducted by Dr. Igor Lumelius, consisted of putting guinea pigs, called butterflies, under hypnosis in order to lock them into a deep sleep. Patients, lost in the maze of their sleep, had to explore every corner of their own dreams in order to find their own way out, and thus be able to wake up. Each of these experiments, all conducted in the same room with dilapidated green walls, were recorded, transcribed, and carefully archived. Here are their dreams.
I'm going to count to 10, and on 10 you will be completely asleep. 1. Take a deep breath. 2. You perfectly relaxed. 3. Let my voice be your guide. 4. You walking towards a light. 5. A light that is getting brighter. 6. You feel totally safe. 7. The light is getting brighter and brighter. 8. Now you let yourself go. 9. Let the light surround you. 10. You're in deep sleep now. You're in deep sleep.
Thank you.
How will the love come down from 10 to 0? And on 0, you will be completely awakened. Totally here and now. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. You are awakened.
I am the doctor Igor Lumelius, and you are in the hospital that I run. There has been an intrusion tonight, and 6 pages of the confidential file of Alexeyev Leonid have disappeared. They must be here because there is no way someone could escape the hospital. Would you mind helping me? If you help me, I will take you to his room, and I will show you the file of Alexeyev Leonid. Information regarding Butterfly Number 1. Name, Alexeyev Leonid. Born on June 30, 1908 in Central Siberia. Profession, Officer Submariner. Interned in our hospital on June 20, 1948, after the sinking of the submarine, the Gypnos, off the coast of Greenland. Family status, widowed, no children. His wife, Ludmila Volkova, an astrophysicist, killed herself on August 23, 1928 by deliberately setting fire to their house a few days after giving birth to a stillborn child. Following these tragic events, Alexeyev Leonid left to travel across Europe and lived for a few years in Paris. He had a short love affair with a Japanese singer called Kyoko. He joined the Russian army in 1935, entering the Submariner's company until the shipwreck of 1948. Since that day, the passion still has the same dream, locked away in his deepest memories and fears. This is an opportunity for us to learn more about the nature of recurring dreams. End of recording.